Hello, everyone. Welcome to the ISU Up Again campaign and What to Watch series. I'm your host, Ted Barden, and as we continue to look back at some special moments and the skaters who provided them, it's my great pleasure today to speak with the exciting and dynamic dance team and the 2019 World Junior Ice Dance Champions from Canada, Marjorie Lajoie and Zachary Laga. Welcome, guys.
Hello.
Hi.
Thanks for taking the time to speak with me today. Now, look, you know, first I have to ask you about how you've coped with the COVID world. You were Canada's number two ranked team heading to the World Championships in your own hometown in Montreal. And then, as we all know, everything on planet Earth simply stopped. What were your thoughts and emotions over the last several months and how you have coped? Let's start with Marjorie.
It was very hard to not do the World Championship in Montreal, where we live and where we train. But after the team did some Zoom and we did dance, we did off-ice, so we trained a lot during quarantine, and I think that was great for us. And now we're back on the ice.
Zach?
Yeah. I think that everybody was like a bit disappointed because, like, obviously, like, it was Worlds in Montreal and we had the chance to train in the Bell Center and like to see like how like the hotel was going to be, you know, the banquet was going to be something like amazing. And yeah, so that was disappointing. But at the same time, there was some good thing about it. Like now we're going to keep our, you know, our spots for next Worlds. And that was maybe something that wasn't going to happen because Laurence and Nick were not going to compete. And we finished great at Four Continents. We had a really, really good result there. So it finished well at the end of the year. So for us, of course, like, it was disappointing, but there were some good points.
Well, look, you guys are still very young. Marjorie, you're 19, I believe, and Zach, you're 21. So you've got a great career ahead of you. So lots of time to build off that. It was a pretty sad time. And I know for all of us, because we were quite involved in helping to build the World Championships there. And we were so excited because so many great things were planned. But that's the past, and now we have a new pathway. So, you know, we'll move forward on all of that. Now, I wanted to ask you a little bit about the process, how you teamed up together. Whose idea was it to get together, and did you know each other before?
No. I didn't know Marjorie. She didn't know me. There was, like, I was training in my club back then, and there was one coach. His name is Julien Lalonde.
Yeah.
And he all the time would, like, go and pick on me on, like, and he would say, like, oh, like, you know, I have this girl and, like, she's really good and, like, you'd be good in dance. And I was doing freestyle. I was just like, well, I'm like, okay, then, like, no, I don't really want to do it. Mm-hmm. But he picked on me for like a year almost. So then I was like, okay, like, let's try.
And, okay. So, Marjorie, the big question here, what was your first impression of Zach?
When he was younger, he was really, he still is sometimes in his bubble, but he was really in his bubble. I was like, oh, okay, that's a young boy, and I'm gonna try to skate with him. But when you're, because we were like 9 and 10 or something, we were so young.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't know this guy, and I needed to take his hand, and I was like, okay.
Nah.
But I wanted to do dance so bad. I was just happy to have a tryout and that it worked out.
Yeah, you know, like, we're still in the process of, like, avoiding eye contacts, like, while we're holding boss position and everything.
I know. It's always so awkward when you watch those young dance teams. You know, they know that, okay, I have to hold his hand, but I don't want to hold his hand.
Exactly.
It's hilarious, you know. All the young.
But it's so normal when you're young. And,
oh, like, yeah, it is. Well, it's worked out pretty well so far, that's for sure. Listen, I've watched you over the past several years, like many of the top teams, very, very good technically, although I'm not an expert on that. But I see something very special and unique as a team and in your passionate performances. I really do believe there's something special about you guys, and I wanted you to tell me what you think that might be.
You want to go?
What's special about it?
I don't know. Like, I,
thank you,
I can try and say something. Mm-hmm. I think that what's special about us maybe might be like how hungry we are, and like we never get satisfied with like a result. Like we always want more. We always try to go forward, always try to analyze what we can do best. And really, like I think that's what makes the difference between like maybe us and like the other couple. Of course, like the other couple might be like that. I'm not saying that the other couple aren't.
No, I
But
could.
I think
Go ahead,
yeah.
Marjorie. Go ahead, Marjorie.
Well, I think it's equal for both of us. We are both mad if we don't get the right result, then we will both work very hard and do what. So sometimes maybe someone is more like they will work harder than the other one, but I think in our couple, even though we work very differently, I think we work the same level.
Yeah, well, I can tell you from my perspective, and I've watched you for many years now, is that you are very special in performance. You make a mistake, whatever. That's the rules of the game. But when you watch a performance, you guys skate, it's something at a higher level. It really is. That's just my personal opinion, and I think many other people as well. So, Zach, I have a big question for you. What do you most appreciate about Marjorie?
There's a few things. There's a few things. No, I'm kidding. No, like she's really easy to work with. Like that's for sure.
That's it.
That's the, well, I mean, no, but like I think everybody have to realize how important that is. And by saying that she's easy to work with, that means there's like so much other things that are good about her. You know what I mean?
Okay, I got it. I got it
Yeah, and
now.
all those things are like it's only like a resume. It all goes to she's easy to work with, and like she always goes in a bad mood. There's, you know, like in the couple, sometime, you know, like for no reason, like you run the training and like one is just in a bad mood and you kind of don't know why. And when you say something like he or she answer like you know, like not like a bit grumpy, you know what I mean? But with Marge, like, it's like this almost never happened. Even if she like she's grumpy, like you won't really like notice it.
No,
And this is really good.
you're right. Marjorie, as much as I know you guys, that Marjorie's always has a smile on her face and always
Yeah.
a pretty happy person. Marjorie, what makes Zach also such an important part of the team?
He's a very hardworking person and he always bring ideas. So when we're working alone, he will always know what to work and we work very I think Gemma
Smartly.
smartly. So we don't take time to just talk about life and like we work very hard and yeah, he's a hardworking person, very hardworking person.
Well, that's fantastic. Now, look, you guys work with an extraordinary group of coaches. I mean, led by Marie-France Debray, Patrice Lauzon, Roman Hagenauer, Pascal Denis, José Pichet, Benjamin Brisebois, to mention just a few.
It's
And
good
there are.
don't forget anyone. It's good that you don't forget anyone.
Yeah, well, I know
It's
I've
not
got
only
idea.
the
I've got idea.
excuse.
Yeah.
It's a big thing.
And many others, I think, off ice as well. It's an extremely special environment. Otherwise, there wouldn't be so many great teams from around the world who actually are highly competitive with each other. What are the keys to making that environment work so well?
You know, there's a lot of teams there. Okay, so the coach are like they're doing really good job on the ice. You know, they help you and everything. And like, I think that right now, like on the ice, and if we're talking about like the philosophy of the technique and like choreographically and everything, it's the best school in the world, in my opinion. You know, well, no, it's like one of the best schools in the world. Okay, like obviously, but what's really good about this school also is that there's like you got to be mature if you want to have success there. You know, you cannot always count, you know, like you have to count on yourself and you gotta want, like you have to want the result. You know what I mean? Like, okay, that was a really bad sentence, but like you need to come from yourself, you know, and the coach are here to help you. And this is why the schools makes a lot of like good athletes is because the athletes want to be champions by themselves and then the coach are here to help you.
Yeah.
Marjorie, do you have any comment?
Well, that's very well said. Every coach are different and they all have their own opinions on thing. And I think this is very great because they all bring their ideas and the stuff we do and we take what's best for us. And yeah, it's a very complete team, I think.
It's I coached for 25 years myself and I know how hard it is to do that. I can't imagine how difficult it is to manage not just what has to be taught on the ice, but manage the personalities and the emotions that you ride up and down as a team. Now, final question before we get into your program. What do you see for the skating, your skating career over the next few years? Of course, your first and seniors, your silver medal at Canadian Championships. You didn't get into the Senior World Championships this year because of the COVID, but what can we expect from you over the next 3 or 4 years?
I don't know what to expect really. Like, one thing is sure is that me and Marjorie right now are working really hard on our weakness. Like, we know what we have to work on. I don't know, this expectation things are really difficult. You know, me and like Marjorie and me, we never really focus on like really like
results.
No, like on long term goals.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
We never really focus on that. You know, like right now, we only think about like we need to improve like those elements, those parts of our skating, and let's see where that's gonna bring us. And when it's gonna be done, okay, there are gonna be other things to work on. You know.
Wow. And that is why you're a good team, because it's not, you can't plan too far down the road. You work every day. Nicely said. Well, look, let's now go back in time and revisit your World Junior title free dance. I've watched it again and again and find it always so inspiring. Really, I do. It's truly a great performance as you skated to the driving emotions and of the beautiful Warsaw Concerto. Let's take a look and you talk us through it. Canada, Marjorie Lajoie,
Zachary Laga. I remember hearing to do a deep breath and looking around and being like, oh my god, I could be a junior world champion after this program. So yeah, I remember I was like, it's now.
It's now.
I usually always want to cry on my presentation all the time. The first part of the program was actually really good. Then the like second and third part, but like the first part. Here's like, this part is really like tricky because like I gotta exit the lift at one point, and if I miss this point, it's kind of like messed up like the rest of like sequence.
I love
so
that.
That was like, yeah, thank you. Very good.
Well, here you're like, we're going into the twistle. That's such a, it's a twistle element for everyone, I think. So I was like, okay, do it.
You guys,
yeah, I remember we were too fast, ahead of the music. So then I said like, come down, Marge, because I knew that like we were gonna do like too fast.
That was beautifully
done. Yeah. Thank you.
Did you hear me? When I said it?
Yes, I did. Okay. Yes, I did. I remember. Yeah.
And what part of this program did you enjoy most to do?
The first part. The first part is good. It's the most powerful.
Yeah, for me, also the first part and the last one when we're just done and we're doing the sliding and we're like,
here
all open. Yeah, here. Woohoo! Yeah. I was like,
okay,
it's okay.
And here I saw Romain going like a bit more like, he said like, calm down or something. So like here, basically, it's like the hardest elements are done. We just try to like enjoy our lines, you know?
Yeah.
Take it easy. Now it's like a bit more. Like,
yeah, there's not a special element that is, I mean,
yeah,
trying to enjoy the moment and see how it is.
Well, one of my favorite parts is this pickup to this lift right here, jumps in, and the speed at which you turn here, Zach, just amazing. To the highlight of the music, Marjorie, mm-hmm. you had a smile on your face. I'd be dizzy like crazy. And look at that, just beautiful emotion working with the music. It's so inspiring. Beautiful.
Thank you.
Yeah, here the footwork is coming and the music is very intense, and we're at the end of the program, so we're like, we love that because we can perform and give everything we have, because it's the end and it's a very important element.
Yeah, here I was like, right here, it's cool, you know, it's like, oh my god.
Oh, that's a beautiful slide. Beautiful slide there, Zach, looking up.
I remember there, the cameraman was like, it's
like right here, yeah.
Yeah, well, yeah.
Right there, whoa!
Yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah.
Oh, that was such a good moment here. Wow. We knew we did it good. Like, that, we knew.
That's a moment. I know it's a moment for you guys because you got to skate it and feel it. But for a viewer, totally gives you chills down your back. Because you see a lot mm-hmm. of really nice performances, but only – and I'm an old dog, so, you know, I've watched a lot of skating in my life. When I see a performance that gives me chills, that's something very special, and that's what I was talking about. You guys did that on that night. And hopefully many more to come, you know. Just beautiful. Just beautiful. Well, you both are exciting and wonderful skaters with unique personalities that makes for interesting and exciting performances for all of us to watch. Thank you for your work. Thank you for taking the time today to speak to me. You have been watching a special presentation of the ISU Up Again campaign. I'm Ted Barton. Thank you for watching. Goodbye, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.